Hi, this is Phil from PDQ Merchant Enterprises and ATM Mastermind Group page. And in today's video, we'll be talking about the top five ways to make my ATM business more profitable. So here we go, the top five ways to make my ATM business more profitable. So point number one, have a solid contract in place. This is my number one go-to move on every situation is always have a solid contract in place. We don't call them contracts, we call them ATM agreements. But this is a surefire way to ensure that you're gonna stay in the location as long as possible. If you wanna sell your ATM business, this gives you an exit strategy and gives your ATM business value. It also spells out what you're gonna do in the ATM location and what the customer or the merchant can expect from you having the ATM in the location. Also spells out surcharge, how much they're gonna get, and how much you're gonna get. So this is the surefire and the best way to keep yourself in the game. Also, a lot of store owners, they don't own their own building. In the event that the ATM business, you know, leaves, or the business in there leaves, not the ATM business, but the business leaves, that's the convenience store, gas station, whatever, you can get your ATM out of that location and save you thousands of dollars. But it's by far my number one tip in almost every situation is to have a solid ATM location agreement. And don't forget to also have an automatic renewal if your state will allow it. Or let's say if you have a 5-year agreement, you're gonna put in another automatic renewal when your agreement is up for another 5. This will help get you to have almost like a 10-year agreement, really without having any kind of negotiation for the next 5. Point number two, make sure your ATM is bolted down. I don't know how many times I go to an ATM location, the ATM isn't bolted down. And sometimes, you know what? Store owners, when they're in desperate needs, they do things, they leave the door open. Sometimes the staff leaves the door open and all of a sudden my ATM decides to grow legs and get out of location. This is a way, make sure you bolt down your ATM. A lot of guys, they put cement bags in there, they put weights in there. And the next thing you know, somebody jerked the ATM and then it walked out the door. So one of my surefire ways to make my business more profitable is don't get robbed. And if you bolt it down, you minimize your ability to get robbed and your ATM walks out by somebody just said, I don't know, it was here yesterday. Well, it's gonna stay here today too. And that's why we always bolt down our ATMs. For me, and I tell you that in a lot of videos, it's a deal breaker. I can't bolt it down. That means I have to be at risk and I don't wanna be at risk. I know some people said, well, the store owner doesn't want us to bolt it down. Well, that's fine. Then the store owner can give us a $10,000 earnest money in case the ATM decides to leave. And most insurance companies, if not all, will not cover you if the ATM isn't bolted to the floor. So one of the things we do to ensure this is always bolt down our ATM. So I help hundreds of aspiring ATM owners go from zero to ATM business pro in as little as 30 days. So if you're thinking about starting a profitable ATM business but don't know how, so stay to the end of the video and I can show you how to start the right way, even if you have zero ideas about the ATM business. Point number three, we add a surcharge percentage. So Phil, what's that? So with each ATM, you have the ability to do a surcharge and or a percentage. So what this looks like, $3 or 2%, whichever is greater. That way somebody takes out, let's say $140, it's $3. If they take out $160, now it becomes $3.20. They take out $400, it's $8. Now this helps you get more percentage. It helps you make more surcharge. It'll raise your game. I don't suggest you do it in every location, but a lot of locations, this helps out. Some of the mom and pop bars doesn't work out so good, but on convenience stores and a lot of hotels, tattoo parlors, it works out great. So if you wanna look at any of those locations and say, well, how do I make more money? You can, you know what, allow them to take out a little bit more, test the waters. Do it at $300, see if that makes a difference. Put a percentage, $300 and or $3 and or 2%, and let them take $300 out. Then you can raise it up to 4. I know guys are doing 8. I'm not a big fan of $800. I think that's overkill. It requires us to put more money in there and keep it just in case. I'm not a big fan, but you know what, $300, in some locations, $400, it's not a bad way. You can increase the surcharge. You can up that percentage or where you're at and you can end up making more money. But keep in mind, sometimes you gotta put a little bit more money in. So you gotta weigh the pros and the cons of that. But I believe overall, in a lot of locations, it's a good idea and it makes you more money. Point number four, look to see where you wanna minimize your cash reserves. You don't need all the money in the ATM all the time. We try to run in in balance. So on this week, we go here, and you know what? We have this much cash threshold that drains down, and then the next week, we're over here. So we're trying to minimize our cash that's out there. I look at it once a week, and then make those changes, $500 here more, $1,000 here more, $500 less. I go in increments of 500 or 1,000, moving the needle either up in sometimes in the summer, we got to put more cash in there. So we're raising it $500, 1,000 for this cycle. And then look at it, evaluate it. Oh, did it work? Did it not? Okay, raise it again. Okay, minimize it. And then on the other way, we're not getting the transaction volumes. Usually in the fall, in a lot of locations, we're starting to some of those summer locations, they're not using as much. We start limiting that cash that's out there, $500 at a time, $1,000 at a time, and say, you know what? This is good. This will last to the next collection period or to the next period where we fill our ATM. We rotate that, so it's not an exact science. So it's not every 7 days. It might be every 7 to 10, somewhere in there, or 10 to 20, depending on where we're at. But we try not to make a target of ourselves and try not to have the same location run at the same time. Something that you guys should also do is, you know what, you should change some of your routes, maybe run it front to back and then back to front, so you're there at different times and different days a week. This helps out to minimize anybody who's looking at you or wants to follow you, so they don't know, oh, this guy's here at 10 o'clock every Tuesday. We try to minimize that. But what you want to do is you want to minimize your cash reserves to keep the cash on the street. Some of you guys are borrowing money, some of it's your own money. You know what? Keep the cash reserves less on the street, more in your control, you'll be better off. And point number five, you should be constantly looking at your route and say, okay, this pull a 6 month journal, pull 12 months and say, okay, I'm doing 50 transactions, 40, 30, 10. Oh, you know what? I think it's time for me to move out of this location. You get another location, don't buy another ATM. Hey, we sell ATMs, I'd sell it to every day but Tuesday. Oh, Tuesday's good too. We're gonna sell you an ATM. Sometimes you just got to look at your route and say, you know what? I'm not going to buy another 1, 2, 3 ATMs. I'm going to go into these locations. We're going to pull those ATMs. And that way you can save yourself thousands of dollars by buying new. You know what? It's time for us to reevaluate this route. Go talk to these owners. You know what? When we went in here, we were giving you a dollar. You know what? Your location isn't doing what you said it was. You were going to get rid of your credit card. Now you're not. You're going to change your hours. Now you're not. You were going to do X, Y, and Z. Now you're not. We can no longer give that percentage or that surcharge amount to you. We want to keep you in the ATM route, but it doesn't justify us being here anymore. If you'd like, what we can do is we can just say we get 100% of surcharge, amend that agreement, sign a new 5-year agreement. Don't just sign it, have them sign it. Now you can say, you know what? I might want to sell it, move it off to somebody else. Now you can just take that cash and put it into something else. Or you know what? You might say, you know what? Even if I sold it, it's not worth anything. I'm just going to pull the ATM. You can always offer it to the location or say, look, here's what we'll do. We'll sell you the ATM. We'll do a maintenance program with you and we'll just charge you X whatever for that a month, maybe in surcharge money. And now you know what? That owner's filling the ATM. They bought the ATM. It's them. You're making positive cash flow. You don't have to worry about anything. Now you move on to the next deal. So there's always ways to manipulate it and make it better for you. Sometimes the deals change, location changes, and it's time to get out of that deal. And sometimes, you know what? You might say, well, I don't mind staying there, but I don't want to own the ATM anymore. Let them do that. That way, maybe a new owner comes in and you can get rid of it and you can go back into that deal. So I hope all those tips are helpful. Suppose you want to start up your own ATM business. I want to invite you to my free training entitled ATM Business Passive Income Checklist. The top things you need to start a profitable ATM business. In this checklist, I'll share with you the top 5 things you need to start a profitable ATM business so you can start building your passive income source for your family. You'll have a clear roadmap towards ATM business success so you can earn $250 to $1,500 of passive income dollars every month. So you can start earning passive incomes, make more money, and spend more time with your family. Click the link down below to get this free checklist. Again, this is Phil from PDQ Merchant Enterprises and the ATM Mastermind Group page, where we buy your freedom back one transaction at a time. Thank you guys very much.